All right, Coach. 3-7. Missouri comes in, and you guys really got to take into it. Look like a little bit tonight. Guys like Nick, really, Nick. I mean, I've never seen Nick as look get dominated the way Nick got dominated by Waters tonight. 149. You guys look like you ran out of gas. 57, 97. Two bright spots, and obviously small look good. But you know, what do you guys got to do? You know, you got two guys out. You're probably looking maybe to go 5-5. You go 3-7. What are your thoughts?
Well, you hit a lot of it on the head. You said most of the stuff there. We were hoping to go 5-5 and maybe get a pin like we did at small, but we never expect to get pinned in four-way classes. Like I said, if you look individually, we had some real good bright spots. We had Sassy who came out and fought. He's a 49-pounder. We bumped him to 65 because we had a guy injured. Mally wrestled one of his better matches again. Small does what he's been doing all year. So those are the bright spots. And then, you have situations where Nick just looked flat. I don't know if it's been a hard – hard few weeks for us. I don't know if anyone has as tough a schedule as we've had in the country, to be honest with you. Now, are we going to sit there and use that as an excuse? No, but it's been a tough go. It doesn't get any easier. We got Ohio State, the 6th-ranked team on Sunday, so it's not going to get any easier. We just need to fight a little bit harder, be a little more respectable when you come out there. And, you know, we told these guys, hey, when you're out there, you know, there's going to be 2,000, 3,000 people here to watch you wrestle, and they're going to be looking at me, and they're going to be looking on the bench, they're going to be looking at you, and you need a little more fight. And after we get through Ohio State, our schedule, we go into a lot more conference matches, and it lightens up a little bit. We don't have to travel as much, so it gets easier. This is, like I said, we're probably in a valley right now. The season's peaks and valleys, and you travel to Vegas, and, we got two guys hurt out there. You spend all day traveling, Sunday coming back, and your time is messed up, and it affects the rest of the week. At least it did for me. I'm assuming my guys probably felt the same way. And like I said, these aren't excuses, but these are reasons why, as a coach, you look and say, all right, maybe we just weren't wrestling our best. Maybe this was what was going to happen, and it didn't matter who we wrestled. When you're wrestling the 11th team in the country, you can't have you can't wrestle bad and expect to win. And Nick wrestled horrible, and you can't expect to wrestle the 5th-ranked kid and expect to win. And like I said, there's different situations where we just weren't very sharp today. And I would think they're going to come out and have a little more fight on Sunday, and then, like I said, at that point we'll sit back and we'll regroup. We have finals next week. We'll give our guys some time to recover, and like I said, then we get back in the conference, and like I said, we're not going to see too many teams in our conference are as good as Missouri and Ohio State, so we'll be all right, and we'll concentrate on just getting better individually, and like I said, hope that we can be a little more, do a little bit better than we did tonight when our home crowd again.
What do you say to your guys? You just had a talking to them out there. What do you say to them to not go 2-8 or 1-9 against Ohio State?
I don't think you worry about winning or losing. You worry about going out and fighting hard and not getting pinned and wrestling your best. Like I said, if that's Nick Bellion's best, then I have no problem with that. If that's Brendan Barlow's best, I've got no problem with that. If that's Ian Miller's best that he can do for 7 minutes, and then I'll deal with it. But I think all three of those guys can wrestle better, for example, and that's what we told them. We said, if this is the best that you're wrestling, then we're all right with it. But if you can do better, then we need to figure out how to get you to do that on a more consistent basis. And like I said, we had two upsets that I thought Keith Witt looked very, very good today against a pretty tough kid. So you got to take the bright spots, you got to go with them, and then you got to get the guys who didn't wrestle the best to try to pick it up for Sunday. And like I said, Sunday doesn't determine our season either. Just because it's Ohio State and we want to win real bad, and regardless of what happens, that doesn't determine our season. Our season is going to be decided in the first two weekends of March. And like I said, I don't think there's too many teams in our conference that are comparable to Ohio State and Missouri. So, even though this is what our goal was this week, we're going to just keep on working hard, and we're going to keep on getting better and keep on developing our wrestlers. So by the end of the year, we'll be healthy, we'll be ready to go, and, get some of our juice back that we need.
All right, you got anything for him?
You had two starters out today. Talk about how big of a difference that made today.
Well, I think, I think you take two starters out, and you had the fact that Nick went out there and wrestled bad. And I was in as much shock as probably the whole stands were. I think, it's one thing for Nick to go out and lose, but he just didn't look very good. And then, then Mischief goes out and doesn't do very much. He gets pinned right away. And, Small brought us back up, but I think, someone's like even Ian Miller. Ian Miller was up 6-3 and just, or 6-2 and just.
Great first period.
Yeah, couldn't wrestle anymore. He was just too tired. Now, he was injured. He had some things going on with him that like you said, he couldn't practice because of, so he was injured. Like I said, so these are little things we have to just work on. And our biggest thing as a staff has always been getting all 10 wrestlers to wrestle good on the same day. And like I said, today we had two or three kids wrestle very, very good, but we had the other seven that didn't do their best, or didn't wrestle their best. And as a coach, you're trying to get 10 guys to wrestle the best on the same day and to be able to compete with them. And I can tell you, some of their guys didn't wrestle the best. I can tell you their 57-pounder is much better than what he did today. But if we can go out Sunday and all 10 guys wrestle our best, I know it'll be a competitive match. I'm not saying we're going to beat them. I'm not going to say that we can get beat 10 matches to zero. But I can tell you it could be some pretty darn good individual matches if all our guys wrestle their best. And that's all we can ask from them.